हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू वावाईएस, वेलकम टू द डिस्कशन ऑन द डेली एमसीक्यू। आज है 26 जून 2021 और अब हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं आज के पांच करंट अफेयर बेस्ड एमसीक्यूज। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। सो लेट अस डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन दैट वाज आस्क्ड ऑन 24th, व्हिच इज इन विच स्टेट विरूपाक्ष टेम्पल इज लोकेटेड, एंड सम ऑफ यू हैव गिवन द करेक्ट आंसर एज वेल। सो इट वॉज दिव्य वशिष्ठ एंड शुभम भाषक हु गेव द करेक्ट आंसर। नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस दिस आंसर। सो द विरूपाक्ष टेम्पल इज लोकेटेड इन हम्पी, which is there in Karnataka, Hampi in Karnataka. This Hampi is actually, it was the famous capital of the Vijayanagar Empire. And this Hampi is a UNESCO World Heritage Site, And if you see, one of the famous king, it is Krishnadevaraya, who was the famous king of this Vijayanagar Empire. Theek hai? So, and there are other important temples which are located near to the Virupaksha temple in Hampi. They are Vittala temple and the temple near the Hemukunta hill, on this Hemukunta hill you have the Jain temple as well as the monolithic sculpture of the Lord Narasimha. So that's why this is important. This hill is important, right? So these are the things that are available, and also the architecture is known as Aihole Pattadakal style architecture. The architecture for this. Okay. Now let's move on. And small information, guys. Daily we are uploading the MCQs and their solution, which is based on the current affairs, in this PDF format in our Telegram channel. You can download it from there. Our intention is simple: to make your preparation easy. For that only we are bringing all these initiatives, because you don't have much time to prepare current affairs in the MCQ format. Okay, so that's why we are doing this for you. So make the best use of this initiative so that you can prosper and you can excel in the exam. Okay, so now let's begin. So the first question: Scenic Island, which is sometimes seen in the news, is located in Scenic Island. Okay, A. Caribbean Sea, B. Andaman Sea, C. Baltic Sea, and D. South China Sea. So we have to tell the correct answer, and the correct answer is B, Andaman Sea. So recently what happened is, the Indian Coast Guard has rescued 9 crew members from a sinking vessel off this Scenic Island. The Scenic Island is actually located between the Passage and the Duncan Island, towards the north of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So remember only one thing: Scenic Island is located near the Andaman and Nicobar Island. Okay, so that's the important thing. And the Scenic Island shares its boundaries with the Vandoor Marine National Park, and is commonly referred as the Mahatma Gandhi Marine National Park. And the passage between North Scenic Island and Rutland is the Manor Strait, and the passage between South Scenic and North Scenic is Scenic Strait. So these are not much important, but the important one is, remember the location of this Scenic Island. Okay, and this Scenic Island is located near the Andaman and Nicobar Sea. That is the important information. Okay. Well, let's move on to the next question, the second question. Consider the following statements with respect to the electoral trust scheme. So we have to choose the correct answer. First statement: it was notified by the Central Board of Direct Taxes. The second statement: the sole objective of this electoral trust is to distribute the contributions received by it to the political party registered under the Section 29A of the Representation of People Act 1951. Okay. So here the correct answer is C, both 1 and 2. Okay, see, both 1 and 2 is the correct answer. So this electoral trust scheme was introduced in 2013 with an act of parliament, right? So after this, it was notified by the CBDT, the Central Board of Direct Taxes, right? So recently, why this was in news is, a trust called the Parivartan Electoral Trust, this has anonymously disbursed 3 crore rupees which it received from Birla Corporation in 2019-20 using the electoral bonds. This trust is not giving information to whom this money was given, and the trust says under the electoral bond scheme there is no anonymity can be maintained under this electoral bond scheme. The parties which are receiving more than 20,000 rupees, okay, their details can be kept as anonymous. So that's the important thing. So that's why under this electoral bond scheme, the Parivartan Electoral Trust says that they are not going to disclose who has received all these funds. See, the main intention of this electoral trust is bringing more transparency in the system, because as we know, the political parties, they are receiving all the funds, like the black money and everything, and this is crippling our system. So in order to ensure that these type of frauds don't occur, we have introduced this electoral trust scheme so that people can get more information about the funds, where they are going and how they are going. But the electoral trust says that they are not going to disclose information because they have received bonds with regarding to the money, and this bonds, under this bond scheme, electoral bond scheme, they are not going to disclose information. So that's the thing, right? And as I've told already, it is notified by the Central Board of Direct Taxes, okay? And the provisions related to the electoral trust are under the Income Tax Act of 1961 and Income Tax Rules of 1962. Okay? And all the funds and all, they will go to the registered political parties which are registered under the Representation of People Act of 1951. And some other extra information we have given, just you can just go through it, okay? From whom the political parties can receive contribution and who cannot donate to the political parties, all this information is given. You can just pause and go through it. If you have any doubt, if you have any query, you can just ask us in the comment box and we'll get back to you. Now let's move on to the third question. So Mission Karmayogi, which is sometimes seen in the news, is associated to A. creating jobs for millions of migrant workers who returned home during the pandemic, B. training to thousands of candidates as yoga instructors and trainers, C. national program for civil services capacity building, D is rehabilitation of children working in hazardous occupations. So we have to choose the correct answer, and the correct answer is C, the national program for civil services capacity building. So as you all might have known, the civil services, the main problem is capacity building. New skills are not being added to the civil servants because the world is changing very fast, but their skills are not upgrading to that extent, okay, which the world is demanding. So that's why the government has launched this innovative mission called the Mission Karmayogi. So recently, why it was in news is former Infosys CEO S.D. Sibulal, he was appointed as the chairperson of the 3-member task force to help the government in bringing major bureaucratic reform through its ambitious Mission Karmayogi. Okay, so this Mission Karmayogi, this task force basically, it will draw a clear roadmap for the guidance and operationalization of this Mission Karmayogi. Okay, and this will be done through a special purpose vehicle as well. So the main intention of this Mission Karmayogi is capacity building for the civil services. Okay, so that there will be a shift from a rule-based training to role-based capacity development, because the civil services, okay, they are mostly dependent on the rules, but not on the output. So that has to be changed. The mindset has to be changed. And also a lot of rules have to be amended for that. So for all of these things only, this Mission Karmayogi is launched. So if you want to know the more pillars, here I've given the pillars of Mission Karmayogi: the policy framework, institutional framework, competency framework, digital learning framework. And this digital learning framework is related to the e-governance, you can say. The electronic human management system and monitoring of evaluation framework. So all of this framework combinedly, they are the important pillars of Mission Karmayogi. Okay, so we'll move on to the next question. Consider the following countries, which are open to the Black Sea. So we have to choose what is the correct answer. First one is Turkey, 2 Russia, 3 Georgia and 4 Germany. So you have to choose the correct answer. And the correct answer is A, 1, 2 and 3 only, because Germany doesn't have any border to Black Sea. Okay, so recently what happened is Russia has alleged that a British warship has breached its territorial waters in the Black Sea, which Britain and most of the world says it belongs to Ukraine. But as you know, Russia has annexed Crimea, and from then there is a tussle between Russia and the West, you can say. So that's why this has become a major issue. So Russia even fired some bombs saying that the British vessel has to move away from that. Okay, so that's why this was in news. And the Black Sea, as it was in news, this will become very important for us, because recently there have been a lot of issues surrounding that Black Sea. That's why this will be very important for us. Now we have to know which are the countries that are surrounding Black Sea. So Black Sea, if you see here, I've given clearly. So the countries surrounding are Turkey, Bulgaria, okay, Romania, Ukraine. Here you can see Russia, Georgia. So all of these countries are surrounding the Black Sea. Now, is there a technique to remember all of these countries? Yes, there is a technique. And the technique is, I'm writing here, the burger. Black Sea is related to burger. Remember this. So here T, this T stands for Turkey. This T stands for Turkey. And this B stands for Bulgaria. U stands for Ukraine. R stands for Romania. G, E. So here you can add small e for your benefit. So G, E stands for Georgia. And R stands for Russia. Right? So this is how you can remember the countries which are surrounding Black Sea. There is a very high chance that a question can come in exam directly this year. So you have to remember this. And some other information if you see. So here it is given clearly. The Black Sea is connected to the Sea of Azov by the Strait of Kerch. So this is Sea of Azov. So you have Kerch here. So this is called the Strait of Kerch. Okay. And the Black Sea is connected to the Mediterranean Sea. This is Mediterranean Sea here. And the Black Sea is connected to this via, here you can see, to the Bosphorus Strait. You have the Bosphorus Strait here. Okay. So that's another important thing. And yeah, that's it about this question. Now we'll move on to the next one. The term Goldilocks zones, which is often seen in the news, is in the context of, this is a civil services previous year question of 2015. A, the limit of habitable zone above the surface of the earth. B, regions inside the earth where shale gas is available. C, search for earth-like planets in the outer space. D, search for meteorites containing precious metals, Goldilocks zone. Okay, so here the correct answer is C, search for earth-like planets in the outer space. So normally habitable zone is generally known as the Goldilocks zone. So habitable zone means where humans can survive, where species can survive. This is called as habitable zone. And this zone which is surrounding a star is known as the Goldilocks zone. Normally, we will be exploring various galaxies and we will try to find whether the life exists anywhere or not. So during this exploration, first thing what we will do is we will try to identify the Goldilocks zone. The Goldilocks zone is that zone which is neither too hot nor too cold. Because only in these conditions, the life can actually survive. If you see Mercury, Venus, these planets are too hot. And if you see planets like Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune and Pluto, these are very cold. It is only on Earth, it is only this Earth which is actually neither too cold nor too hot, and that is the reason we will have life on Earth itself, right? Okay, now let's move on to the question of the day. So the question of the day is, currently which states have legislative councils? You have to comment the states in the comment box. Tomorrow we will discuss this question. So as tomorrow is Sunday, yeah, it is on Monday we are going to discuss this question. Okay? So that's it, friends. Before I leave, a small information regarding our initiatives. We are concising all the important materials for you from the examination point of view. We are trying to concise each and everything without leaving any information so that you can get the maximum benefit out of it and you will be able to revise the materials n number of times, which is very important for the prelims. We have concised the 100 page vision economy into about 50 pages. Don't you think this is easy for you for your revision? And also the same thing we have done for the mains test series, vision prelims test series and vision monthly magazine. You can just visit our Telegram channel which have the details of all of these initiatives, and we have given even the sample documents as well. You can just go through them, right? So that's it, friends, for the day. I'll see you again on Monday with 5 more current affair based questions. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.